Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my another playlist where I will be talking about TypeScript. Okay, as we all know, the TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. We will see how we can use TypeScript to write our Angular application, our React applications, or our simple JavaScript application. Because TypeScript is providing us the type safety, and this is what we need when we compare the JavaScript with any other programming language where they are providing the type safety. So we will be using TypeScript with JavaScript to add a type safety in the application. Okay. So first we will talk about the introduction and basic parts of the TypeScript. Then gradually we will talk about the code snippets, how to write the classes, interfaces, enums, with the help of TypeScript. Okay, little bit about me. I'm Tarun Sharma and this is my YouTube channel. So what we are going to cover is, what is a TypeScript? Why we should use TypeScript for writing a JavaScript application? How it work and how the TypeScript is getting compiled? Because we are adding a compiler on top of JavaScript. Okay, then we'll talk about fundamentals of TypeScript. So TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript. Whatever we have, that code will be compiled by TypeScript. Okay, there will be no any error. But if you are adding a type safety, like you are declaring a variable x as a boolean with the type safety, then you cannot assign x to some integer or some number, right? That is the type safety which TypeScript is providing us. Okay, and TypeScript was provided by Microsoft now, and then it gets integrated with Angular. Now it is open source. TypeScript can be installed and can be used with any JavaScript framework. Okay, so JavaScript is great, right? Let's make it great again. JavaScript has, like, variables can hold any type of values. Even you declare the value with the lat or with the var keyword, you still be able to change the type. For x was 10, then x equal to some string. So the variable is not holding the type, it is a floating. Initially you initialize that variable with the number, now you are assigning a string. Same thing with methods, functions, and everywhere, right? So JavaScript is providing the implicit type conversion, and like string to the number to the string. If they are compatible, then it's fine. But that should not happen, right? We should ensure that method should return only whatever we are expecting from the method. Okay. Sorry. So JavaScript without the patterns is like code look smelly, right? Because there may be a loophole where your code will break when you are converting one type to another type. But with the TypeScript, where we are adding the type safety of each and every variable of the each and every function, each and every declarations, each and every type, we are using interfaces, classes, enums, and different types of TypeScript, then everything will be foolproof. We can compare these then with the other languages like Java, PHP, because they are providing the type safety. And now when we are adding TypeScript with the JavaScript, we are also adding the type safety for our application. So the overall picture is, we are adding a compiler at the development time. So development time will slightly increased, but at the runtime, whenever the interpreter need to take care of the types, it doesn't need to care about the types, because we have already explicitly specified, okay, the x will be of type number, y will be of type string. So we don't need to deal with the type conversions, and there will be no errors coming at the runtime regarding this. Okay, so JavaScript is a TypeScript. We are using the interfaces, we will be using the classes and all. So you can see that we are creating a variable as an integer, right? So foo, we are assigning a string here, right? So we will get error. can't assign a string to a number. So earlier foo is a number, and foo is assign, you are assigning that to some number, right? It still compiles, it will not give you the error at this particular stage, right? Because it is fine that you are, initially it was a number and now you are assigning that to the string. So how TypeScript works? TypeScript, we need to install the TypeScript as a module, and you can install that as a global module. And in the TypeScript, we need to write .ts files, not .js files. So TypeScript compiler will use tsconfig.json, where all the instructions are written for the compiler, and then it will convert .ts file, which is written maybe in ES6 or something. Then it will return that file, it will convert or transpile or compile, whatever you call it, it will compile it into .js file. Okay, so you can, so in VS Code Editor, which is also provided by Microsoft, it provides all these kind of the TSLint validations and all. You can install TypeScript something like this. It's a global module, and then you do TypeScript in it, TSC. TSC is a TypeScript compiler. You do TSC and dash in it. It will enable you to create a tsconfig.json. And tsconfig.json will enable you to add the compiler option. So we can customize this, right? We wanted our target output in ES5 or something else. Then tsconfig.json you can configure. You can put all the compiler options and then start using TypeScript. Okay. So first I will show the basic demos from the slides. Then also I will come to the code and will show you the code on the VS Code, how the TSLint is working, how we are writing the TypeScript code, and what is the output of that TypeScript code into the ES5. So fundamentals of TypeScript, these are actually fundamentals. Interfaces, we are using modules, namespaces and regs. This is the good concept which we use in like object oriented language like Java.NET, where we don't know what type of argument we are passing, so we make it as generic, flexible for the functions. Classes is there in the ES6 functions. Interfaces is a new concept with the help of TypeScript. Modules and namespaces, we are also able to create a modules, namespaces and enum. To put a fixed set of types, we can create an enum. Okay, now new types has been added in JavaScript with the help of TypeScript. Those are like boolean, string, array, tuple, enum, any, void or never. Okay, so these are the new types, because JavaScript doesn't provide explicit type. We can declare a variable with a string and assign it to the number or something else. But using TypeScript, you need to be specific. You need to assign the type. It can be a boolean string, or it can be of array of number, array of string, tuple, which says either value can be of number or can be of string. Enum is having fixed set of values. Any, it is providing the flexibility. If you don't know currently what is the value, you can put any. And void. Void is used for the functions if they are not returning anything. Okay. So inheritance. I'm just jumping to some code snippets so what I'm considering that you already know ES6 concepts, because you are actually looking for the TypeScript. So you already know ES6 classes, interfaces, module, import, exports, default argument, spread operator, rest parameter, all these basic ES6 concepts you already know. I will also be covering them. So this is the class and here is the name. So the basic thing which I will be covering is, so just take a look onto this earlier. So what TypeScript is adding us in our application is, earlier we used to declare a variable something like this, right? And we are fine. Now x can be changed to some other values and we were not having any compile time error. And if the type conversion is happening properly, then there is no any runtime error also. But with the help of TypeScript, we will have something like this. Now this x is of type string and you cannot assign some any other value. Okay, you cannot say now in the next line x is 50. It will give you the error, right? Because you are violating the rule. X is of type string, you cannot declare it as a number, right? Similarly, currently we are declaring a function, hello, and we are just not checking the parameters a and b we are passing, right? But with the help of TypeScript, we will be able to define the types also. A is of type number, P is also of type number, and what it is returning, it is returning number. The function is returning number. So what it is returning, A plus B, which is also number, right? So we are actually adding the type safety in our application with the help of this snippet. Okay. Okay, so this is an example of the ASX class, where we, the animal class is snake is extending animal and horse is extending animal. So you can see everywhere we have provided the type safety, name is of type string, in the constructor the name is of type string, and in the move method the distance in meter is of type number, all these things, right? Similarly, the animal is being extended by snake and horse is also extending animal. So things are pretty much same, like whatever we are writing in the ES6 classes, we are extending the one class into another class. Only the thing is now we are adding the type safety on top of it. Right, like the functions, we are declaring something like this. Traditional JavaScript functions, we are writing the prototype-based inheritance on top of the functions. Right, classes are providing us the way to define the functions, and it helps to provide implement the prototypical inheritance and blah blah, because classes are nothing but this is a syntactic sugar. They are indirectly using the function prototype for the inheritance in JavaScript. So see, look at this code. This is the function, anonymous functions for the add variable. Here we are using the arrow functions. You can see the x, I have defined the type, for the y, I have defined the type, and this method is returning a type number. So this is clear. I cannot allow this function to return any other thing except number. So we will talk about the ESLint validations and all. Let me open the code in the next video. Then interfaces, you can focus on the type checking of the object. So sometimes we need to pass the object to the function which is having multiple attributes, some R type of number, some R type of string. So we can put a strict validation. Okay, if you are passing some object to the functions or anywhere else, we can strict the type of the properties, like color is of type string, width will be of type number. Okay, now this is actually indirectly we have created a custom type. It's not the interface which you think about of interface in Java or .NET. It's a simple interface and you can create a type. So new square is of type of square config, because it is also having both the same parameters. So this is providing a strict validation. Okay, you are firing an API, you can expect the response. Response will have a two attributes, so you can validate that response is having both the strings or not. Okay, modules and namespaces, we are writing the modules named export and default export we are doing in ES6. So like we have created an interface. An interface is having one value is acceptable. This is a method and it is returning boolean. Okay, so interface, the name looks similar, that interface can extend one interface, can extend another interface, class will implement the interface, and then they need to define the method. So this is the class, it is implementing the interface, and now is acceptable is a method, so we need to define this, that is acceptable method here, which is returning a boolean. Okay, modules and namespaces, you can, so this is the example of basic exports we have created. You can also create a namespaces. What we will do in the namespaces, it is same as a module pattern in JavaScript. So what you are doing, you are wrapping up everything inside a namespace validation. So guys, the important thing is whenever you see all these codes in your, so this is the TypeScript playground which we have. and this TypeScript playground will help us very much. So this is the platform where we can see what is the ES5 code output we are going to get. Okay, so if you see this, so this is the name space validation is the namespace. This is like a module pattern. If you see the final code generated in the ES5, this is the validation, this is the IFE block we have written, and we are passing the validation here, right? Validation either a object or if that is already defined. And we have these methods, string validator, and then we have the class, two classes, both implementing the string validator interface. So classes are being represented here as anonymous function with the IFE block in ES5. This is the first class, this is the second class, and this is wrapped in the module pattern in JavaScript. Okay, so these things are very important, like if you're writing a function, how it is being compiled into the JavaScript, or let's call it as a so look at this code, how it is being compiled, namespace. Oh, it is not showing anything. So this is the code block where you will define your module. So here you can just create your functions. You see this particular block, this is the IFE block, and inside this you have a function hello. And we are now in the IFE block, we are adding this hello function onto the validation variable. You see, this is what I wanted to show you. So everything is getting compiled to the ES5, that all these things you can define in the tsconfig.json, which we will take a look in the next video. Okay, that's it. Thanks everybody.